Welcome back to Palm Breeze Cafe for our free software Smackdown. And actually, we're going to start with a software package that is an app for your phone. And we're going to pass it over to Frank. Frank, you've got a neat one for study purposes.
Okay, as you know, there's an astronomical amount of free apps.
Yes.
Available on the,
it's scary.
On the, for the iPhone and now for also for the Android. So I've kind of narrowed it down. And I think, you know, one of the things that I've seen today is that all of these things that you've seen not only are great, but I mean they're free and they're good for you and they're going to help you get organized. Well, I believe, and every classroom teacher will tell you, the best thing a student can do to learn in anyone's class is to get organized. And usually in the beginning of the year, they spend a lot of time on organization. I've got two little organizational apps I want to show for student use. And the first one I want to show you is called My Homework. Now, how simple can this be? It's a very simple app. What you do is you just log in, and all you do is you enter what your homework is for that day or for that week. So here I have a few things already listed. Now I've got to read math, page 45, and I'm going to go over here, and this is going to show what my class is. I click on my class.
Oh, nice.
And okay, this is my math class. It's course 101, building number 5, room 505, Mrs. White. And then you can add other information, other schedules. And then, so I don't have a lot of classes listed here, but I just wanted to give you some idea what it looks like. And then you would just go here, and you would enter more information on your homework. And it gives you a little alarm and a little alerts about when it's due.
Good.
Okay, that's for the younger set. Now, I've got another app here I want to show for the more advanced student, high school or college student. And this one I really like. It's called iStudiez. Light. So here it gives you the daily calendar. So there would be a list of what's going on today in your schedule. And then down here I'm going to click on the monthly calendar that'll show you, and it'll be, depending on what you have, there'll be little indicators that there's something going on.
That vacation, what about the calorie schedule?
Okay. Oh, that blank one, okay. So here you go. Now I'm looking at my work that I have here, and it says, calculus is overdue. I better check that. What's going on with the calculus? And I'll click on it and say, I was supposed to turn in my 12 problem set. It was due on May 10th with a high priority, and it's not done. So I got to get on the stick here.
Uh-oh. Time's going to be after you for that.
Biology, what do I have to do here? I have biology chapter 8. I've got to read and go online, and it's due May 18th. So priority on that one is particularly low. I can set that priority. I can say, you know what, let's just make that normal priority. Because later what it's going to do is I can just tune in and say, what's my priority today? And it's going to tell me.
Oh, this is good.
Okay, so that's organization. I can go back over here to planner. Here's my semester. I load in all my courses. And this should be, of course, it's going to be done at the beginning of the year. It's going to show me the time. What do I have? I have a lecture from 4 to 5. I've got a study group, and I can even get more detail, and I can click on that, and it can tell me more detail, the dates of my class, the time, when it repeats, the type, who my instructor is, and the location. Now, seriously, if you really think about it, who would not want to be organized, especially in today's world where you're paying a lot of money?
Yeah, I'm not organized about getting organized.
What's that?
I'm not very organized about getting organized.
Do you have to put all that in at the beginning of the semester, or does it interface with?
No, it looks like you have to download it. I didn't see it interface with your course, but that would be
version.
Great if you could do that.
This is light, so there's a bigger version you pay for.
Yeah, and maybe you could do that. I would have to look at that, okay. Though.
So did you have any poetry assignments in there?
Not poetry, but I got a rhyming.
Well, I'll tell you what.
I do have a rhyming app, but
Thyme
I want to hear
is
more
going
about
to
what
show
have.
Us how to use a rhyming app for your desktop. So what have you got here for us?
I have to admit that I have never actually used this, but I'm so geeked up to show it to you because I'm going to start using it.
Right.
I write poems all the time. I write poems all the time.
Poems
all the time for the kids. Like, let's say it's going to be their birthday. Instead of buying invitations and spending money, I go to the computer and I write a birthday poem that's an invitation. You know, mm-hmm. My Peter Pie is turning 10. My Peter Pie is, going to want you when you come, whatever
okay,
it is.
Yeah.
And
Thyme,
it takes me.
Do your whole segment in rhyme, will you? Like Dr.
Good.
Seuss, would you?
But you just did Thyme, do your whole segment in rhyme.
There you go.
Very good, very good. So I do, and I struggle, and sometimes it's midnight, and I'm still trying to write their birthday poem. I actually, for Mother's Day, I just wrote my mom a poem for Mother's Day instead of something material. I thought it would be nice if I went ahead and wrote her something from the heart. And then I find this after the fact. Okay, so here's how you do it.
Okay.
You're going to go to BryantMcGill.com. So www.BryantMcGill.com. And this website actually has a lot of stuff.
Yes, very busy.
It's very, very busy. So you want to go to the far right-hand side.
All the way to the right.
Where it says McGill Site Options, way on the right. There's a McGill homepage, which we are here, about Bryant McGill. And then here it is, Dictionary of Rhyme. Click on the Dictionary of Rhyme. And if you scroll down, you'll see, here's kind of like the advertisement for it, the world's most extensive reference, McGill English Dictionary of Rhyme. It is free.
It's very good.
For songwriters and poets and bloggers and rap artists. And I've actually already done the download, but it's a free download. And if you enjoy this software, all they ask is you were to forward it to your musician friends. And since I've already downloaded it, let me go ahead and minimize this so I can show you what it looks like. Once you've got it, and we actually have a little tab for it here.
Okay.
And it opens up. If you look across the top, there are several tabs.
It's very blank right now.
It is very blank, but it's waiting for you to just create.
So you edit right in this program.
Yes. But I'm going to show you really quick what the tabs are. The main editor is what it opens up. It'll open up with the main tab, the main editor tab. There's a thesaurus tab. There's an online lookup tab. Wikipedia, you know, let me type something in because this is going to be much more interesting if there's a word.
Okay.
And do you have
No, like let's keep it this way. You go ahead.
Okay.
Put in something about one of your kids.
It's, yes? Oh.
Thyme, there you go.
Thyme. And I do have an unusual name. And when you put in Thyme right now on the right-hand side, it's giving you actually words that have to do with Thyme. And it's listing cayenne and oregano.
Pronunciations. Oh, we didn't get anything else on that.
Well, but let's rhyme a whole. So, there was once a teacher named.
So is this
Thyme.
Mac and PC or just PC?
This is just
I
PC.
Think it's just PC.
Okay.
It's only works on a Windows platform now.
Okay. And Mr. Keller, tell me why this is not giving me my rhymes. Doing wrong here.
It's Murphy's Law. Let's take Thyme out of there.
What it's giving on the right-hand side is actual words that are, it's like the thesaurus, so is there a way to unclick?
You mean take this out of the thesaurus?
Right,
yeah, we can take that out.
There we go.
But I don't think that's really affecting it.
Well, go ahead and let's throw Thyme onto the end again. Click me to the end. T-H-Y. Because, of course, we did try this earlier, and...
You know, Murphy's Law, you try it. It won't work.
So earlier, we did that, and what you can do is it'll give you all the different rhymes for Thyme. It's very, very fabulous. And then you can do an A-B-A-B, where it's going to rhyme, you know, every first and third line, second and fourth lines, etc. And then each one of those words will get looked up for you. You can look them on dictionary.com, wikipedia.com. It really, really is neat. I'll be using it. You should, too. And I hope that you come back for more website Palm Breeze Cafe.
Smackdown.